losers tonight.
That's where our political analyst Steve Swatt comes in. Steve.
Well, some of the winners are obvious. John McCain, who solidified his hold on the Republican nomination, and Hillary Clinton, who needed a victory in California really to stop the bleeding because Barack Obama was on a roll nationally. They are splitting all of the delegates that were up for grabs today. But here are a few other winners. Gaming tribes. Four gaming tribes with a few thousand members will gradually but dramatically expand their operations and make a lot more money and also donate about $200 million a year to the state. California voters, for the first time in a generation, we mattered during the primary season. And TV stations nationwide, up to $3 billion will be spent on national, state, and local ads through November. As for losers, at the top of the list, Rush Limbaugh, Sean Hannity, and the other cable and talk radio partisans who have failed to derail John McCain's bid for the nomination. Romney's kids, if Mitt Romney continues the fight, and he says tonight that he will, he'll have to pump in more of his estimated $250 million in personal wealth, money that comes right out of his kids' inheritance. He already has spent about $50 million. And pollsters, they were all over the map tonight, especially in California. One pollster actually had Mitt Romney winning a sizable victory here in California, and I am reminded of what a pollster in Georgia once said. His name was Claiborne Darden. He said, any fool can take a poll, and many do. I also reserve the right to add to the loser's side Fabian Nunez, the Assembly Speaker, and the Senate President Pro Tem Don Parada. Should Proposition 93, the term limit measure, go on to defeat, and right now it's losing about 52% to 48%. And if that trend should continue, then those two gentlemen and several other members of the state legislature will be unemployed.
All right, always fun. Steve Swatt with our winners and losers on this Super Tuesday tonight. Thank you, Steve.